Hello children, in this video we are going to do the book back exercise on the clauses and its type. Okay, in the previous video we have learned about the clauses and its types also. So before starting this exercise, before doing this exercise, let me give you the short recap about the clauses and its types. Okay, so what are clauses? Yes, clauses are the group of words. Only the 3 points you need to keep in your mind. Okay, clauses are the group of words which has subject and verb and which gives us a complete meaning, which gives complete meaning by itself. When we read out the group of words which refer to the clause, it gives a complete meaning by itself only. The first important thing you need to keep in your mind that clauses always comes with the subject and verb. If you find in a group of words, if you find a subject and verb, means they are clauses only. Clear, children? Okay, and about the types of the clauses. What are the types of clauses? There are two types of clauses, that is dependent and independent. Dependent and independent. Dependent and independent, they both have the subject and verb by itself with the group of words. It has the subject and verb, whereas dependent doesn't give a complete meaning, so it gives an incomplete meaning. When you read out the group of words which refer to dependent clause, no, it gives us an incomplete meaning only. When we read out the independent clause, group of words, means that gives us a complete meaning. Complete meaning only. Okay, so they both have a subject and a verb, and they both are group of words only. The only difference is when you read out a group of words and if you understand the meaning of the whatever they are telling, you know, if you understand its meaning, means that refers to the independent clause. It gives a complete sentence. Okay, the complete sentence refers to the independent. The incomplete sentence, when we read out that group of words, it stops something. It may have some what can I say? Yes, you may have some doubt about that. No, what they are trying to say, you don't get. Okay, you don't exactly get the complete meaning. So when the sentence, when the group of words may give the incomplete meaning, means that refers to dependent clause only. Okay, so what do we need to do in this exercise? So let's see. Identify the clause. We need to identify the clause, whether it belongs to dependent clause or independent. If it is a dependent clause, means you need to write in the blank dependent. If it is an independent clause, means you need to write in the blank independent. And this is in your book page number 116 only. That for your reference, I have written the page number also. Okay. So there are 9 questions given in your book bag, but here I have written only the 7. The last 2 you need to try. Okay, try by yourself and do the answers also. Okay. So let's start doing the exercise. First one, the climbers prepared hard. The climbers prepared hard. So here, one more thing, what you need to do. Once if you find out the clauses type, its type means you need to underline the verb also. Okay. First we'll underline the verb. Okay. So the climbers prepared hard. Can you find the verb? Yes, here there is a subject. Next to the subject, that will be the verb only. So here prepare is the verb. Okay, the climbers prepare hard. It means climbers vandu romba prepare, romba kashtama vandu kadinama vandu avanga prepare pannanga. So when I read this group of words, I get the meaning. It means like it feels like it is a complete sentence only. The climbers prepare hard. I can put full stop also because it gives a complete sentence, complete meaning also. So when a group of words, when a clause gives a complete meaning, means it refers to complete meaning, means it refers to independent only. So the answer I need to write is independent. It is an independent clause. Okay, so let's go for the second. Climbing a steep mountain takes months. Climbing a steep mountain takes months. Or a steep mountain means or slope ஆனது. Okay, or slope இருக்கும், செங்குத்தா இருக்கும், இந்த மாதிரி இருக்கும் மவுண்டெயின். ஓகேவா, இந்த மவுண்டெயின்ல கிளைம் பண்ணுறது வந்து, கிளைம் பண்ண நம்ம start panna it takes several months it may take 3 months or 4 months or 2 months okay so andha mari ore mountain nam vandu climb panna start pannana adu vandu nariya maasam aagum appdi solranga so now first we need to find out the verb I'm going to underline what is the verb here which is the verb yes that is take I need to underline takes now climbing a steep mountain takes months here there is a subject and also a verb does it give some meaning or not that is what you need to check okay for because this are all the clauses only they both have the subject and verb the one thing you need to find is whether this group of words and this sentence gives us a complete meaning whether it is a complete sentence we can put full stop or it doesn't give any complete meaning or not if it is gives a complete meaning you can write independent if it doesn't give a complete meaning means you need to write dependent clause only okay so when I read this sentence climbing a steep mountain takes months செங்குத்தான மலையில ஏறுறதுக்கு நிறைய மந்த்ஸ் எடுக்கும் அப்படின்னு சொல்றாங்க சோ when I read it itself it gives a complete meaning by itself am I right இத பார்த்தா நம்ம ஒரு கம்ப்ளீட் சென்டென்ஸ் மாதிரி தான் இருக்கு இத நம்ம ফুল ஸ்டாப் கூட வச்சிரலாம் இல்லையா சோ இது நம்ம இத படிக்கும்போது நமக்கு கம்ப்ளீட் மீனிங் கிடைக்குது சோ when we get the complete meaning or complete sentence means it refers to independent clause so the answer is independent what is the spelling of independent 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 clause okay let's go for the third one because they are determined because they are determined because they are determined ena avanga vandu urudhiya irundanga so when I read this sentence see because they are determined when I read this sentence separately I don't get who are determined yaar vandu determined yaar vandu urudhiya irundanga edhukku urudhiya irundanga indha mari question nam kekkalam illaya because they are determined appdin solumbodhu we here we don't know they are talking about who exactly who and why they are determined avanga edhukku determined ah irukanga namakku theriyadhu but we got the subject and also the verb first thing I need to underline is verb because in the roman itself they have given to underline the verb so ar yaar na underline panniten now I'm not getting the complete meaning from this sentence in the sentence it complete meaning kadikala because they are determined sona ena avanga vandu urudhiya irukanga but yaar urudhiya irukanga edukaga urudhiya irukanga adu nammalku theriyadhu we don't know exactly what they are trying to say it is not a complete sentence so complete ah illa incomplete meaning kodutuduna it refers to dependent only so the answer is dependent clause d e p e n d e p d e n t dependent okay that is the correct answer so let's go for fourth one they will not stop at any hurdle they will not stop at any hurdle அவர்கள் வந்து எதுக்காகவும் எந்த தடைக்காகவும் எந்த தடை வந்தாலும் அவங்க வந்து நிறுத்த மாட்டாங்க அப்படின்னு சொல்றாங்க when I read it this when I read this group of words I get the meaning it seems like it is a complete sentence they will not stop at any hurdle அவங்க வந்து எந்த தடை வந்தாலும் நிறுத்த மாட்டாங்க அது வந்து ஸ்டாப் பண்ண மாட்டாங்க so it is a complete sentence only so when it gives a complete meaning we can write the type of the clause that is independent only and here the verb is will stop is the verb so the answer for this sentence this group of words refer to independent clause independent clause they will not stop at any hurdle avargal edukkagum endha thada vandhalume avanga nirutha maatanga appdin solumbodhu idu or complete meaning namakku therinjiduchu So keep in your mind when it is a complete sentence independent if it is incomplete dependent okay so let's go for fifth one until they become successful so avanga vandu successful aagra varaikum enna pannuvaanga we don't know you read out this sentence alone separately until they become successful na avanga successful aagra varaikum appadina adu mudiyudu varaikum adukku appra enna aagum theriyadhu illaya until they become successful na avanga adu varaikum successful aagra varaikum adukku appra enna pannuvaanga yaar successful aagum edhukaga indha mari question nam raise pannalam appadina நம்மளுக்கு இந்த சென்டென்ஸ் கம்ப்ளீட் மீனிங் கொடுக்கல அப்படினா இட் ரெஃபர்ஸ் டு டிபெண்டன்ட் ஒன்லி அண்டில் தே பிகம் சக்சஸ்ஃபுல் மீன்ஸ் இட் இஸ் எ டிபெண்டன்ட் ப்ளாஸ்மல் பிகாஸ் ஹியர் வி டிடன்ட் கெட் தி கம்ப்ளீட் சென்டென்ஸ் அண்டில் தே பிகம் சக்சஸ்ஃபுல் ஓகே சக்சஸ்ஃபுல் ஆகுற வரைக்கும் அதுக்கப்புறம் என்ன நடக்கும் அது தெரியாது ஸோ வென் இட் டசன் எண்ட்ஸ் வித் அ கம்ப்ளீட் சென்டென்ஸ் மீன்ஸ் இட் ரெஃபர் டு ஷி டிபெண்டன்ட் தி ஆன்சர் இஸ் டிபெண்டன்ட் D-E-P-E-N-D-E-N-D, dependent, is the correct clause for the fifth question, okay? So, let's go for 6-1. They work hard during the day. அவங்க காலையிலலாம் ரொம்ப கடினமாக உழைச்சாங்க ஓகே அவங்க வந்து காலையில் ரொம்ப அதிகமாக உழைக்கிறார்கள் அப்படின்னு நம்ம சொல்ல கடினமாக உழைக்கிறார்கள் ஸோ இப்படி நான் சொல்லும் போது இட்ஸ் எண்ட் திஸ் சென்டென்ஸ் எண்ட் பை இட் செல்ஃப் அண்ட் ஆல்சோ இட் கிவ்ஸ் அ கம்ப்ளீட் மீனிங் இல்லையா அவங்க வந்து ரொம்ப கடினமாக காலையில் வந்து ரொம்ப கடினமாக வேலை செஞ்சாங்க இல்லை நீங்கள் கொஷின் கூட கேட்கலாம் யார் ரொம்ப அதிகமாக வந்து வேலை செஞ்சாங்க அவங்க எப்போ டூரிங் த டே அவங்களே கொடுத்துட்டாங்க ஸோ வென் இட்ஸ் கம்ஸ் வித் அ கம்ப்ளீட் மீனிங் மீன்ஸ் இட் ரெஃபர்ஸ் டு இண்டிபெண்டன்ட் தி ஆன்சர் ஃபார் திஸ் க்வெஸ்சன் இஸ் இண்டிபெண்டன்ட் க்ளாஸ் independent and for the fifth one we need to underline the verb what is the verb here very good become is the verb and for the sixth one yes work is the verb only let's go for the last one what they enjoy the most in the evenings அவங்க ஈவினிங்ஸில் என்ன என்ஜாய் பண்ணுவாங்க என்ன என்ஜாய் பண்ணுவாங்க அப்படின்னு அவங்க க்வெஸ்சன் மாதிரி இட்ஸ் லைக் அ க்வெஸ்சன் சென்டென்ஸ் பட் இட் டசன்ட் எண்ட் வித் க்வெஸ்சன் அவங்க ஈவினிங்கில் என்ன என்ஜாய் பண்ணுவாங்க தெரியுமாங்கிற மாதிரி தான் அது கேட்குறாங்க ஓகேவா ஸோ ஹியர் வி டோன்ட் நோ வாட் தே வில் டூ இன் தி ஈவினிங் அமரே ஸோ வாட் தே என்ஜாய் தி மோஸ்ட் இன் தி ஈவினிங் வி டோன்ட் நோ வாட் தே என்ஜாய் அண்ட் ஹூ தே என்ஜாய் அண்ட் வாட் கைண்ட் ஆஃப் என்ஜாய்மெண்ட் தே ஹேட் வி டோன்ட் நோ ஸோ ஹியர் இட் டசன்ட் கிவ் அஸ் அ கம்ப்ளீட் மீனிங் means it is an incomplete sentence incomplete means we need to write the clause name that is dependent what dependent clause because this sentence it is an incomplete only and here enjoy is the verb So children, what we have done in this exercise? In this exercise, we have underlined the verbs. What are the verbs comes in the group of words? We have underlined the verbs and we have learned about the types of clause. So whether this group of words, this sentence is referred to dependent clause or independent clause. We have identified this sentences are referred to which type of clauses also. So I hope you are clear with this exercise. Try to do the last two questions also by yourself and I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.